we want to find the limit as h approaches 0 of the rational function. We'll find this limit algebraically, and then we'll verify it graphically. Notice if we try to find this limit by performing direct substitution, we would have division by 0, which is undefined. But when we have a rational function like this, we can often simplify it and then find the limit by performing direct substitution. And to simplify this, there are two methods. We can factor or we can expand. And we'll go and look at both methods. Let's first take a look at the factoring technique. To use the factoring technique, we need to recognize that the numerator is a difference of squares because we have the quantity 2 plus h squared, and we can write 4 as 2 squared. So the numerator fits the form of a squared minus b squared, which can be factored as a difference of squares. So we can write this as the limit as h approaches 0, where one factor would be the quantity 2 plus h plus 2, and the second factor would be the quantity 2 plus h minus 2. Our denominator is still going to be a factor of h. And now we're going to simplify the numerator, so we'll have the limit as h approaches 0. Here we'll have 2 plus h plus 2. That's going to be one factor of h plus 4. Here we have 2 plus h minus 2. Well, 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. So this simplifies to one factor of h divided by h. Notice how the numerator and denominator share a common factor of h, which means this graph would have a whole at h equals 0, which does not affect the limit. So this limit is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of h plus 4. Well, as h approaches 0, this approaches 0 plus 4, or 4, which is the value of our limit. Now let's take a look at a second method to determine the same limit. Instead of factoring this, we could expand the numerator and then try to simplify. So we'd have the limit as h approaches 0 of 2 plus h times 2 plus h minus 4 all over one factor of h. Now we'll go ahead and multiply these two binomials. So we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times h is 2h, and then h times 2 is another 2h, so we have plus 4h, plus h times h, or plus h squared, minus 4, all over h. Now we'll go ahead and simplify the numerator. Notice how we have 4 minus 4, that's 0, so we're left with 4h plus h squared, and these two terms have a common factor of h, so go ahead and factor the h out, leaving us with h times the quantity 4 plus h all over h. Notice in this form, we have a factor of h over a factor of h, which again graphically means we'd have a whole at h equals 0, which does not affect the limit, so we can write this as the limit as h approaches 0 of 4 plus h. And as h approaches 0, now we can perform direct substitution. 4 plus 0 is just 4. So even though our technique was different, the result is the same. Now if we take a look at the graph of our function, which we'll call f of h, this would be the h-axis, this would be the f of h-axis. Remember, before simplifying, we had a common factor of h between the numerator and denominator, which would result in this hole in the graph, but this hole does not affect our limit. Notice as we approach h equals 0 from the right side and the left side, we can see we are approaching a function value of positive 4, which verifies our limit is equal to 4 graphically. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.